Here's a situation for you. You're walking on a large metal plate that's covered in sand. All of a sudden, the plate starts to vibrate, and the sand around you arranges in weird eldritch shapes. If this sounds like a typical Tuesday for you, you might be living on a Chladni plate, or in the opening sequence of Rings of Power. In any case, I'm Leonard, and welcome to Useless Game Dev. You might have seen Chladni plates in science class or on your favorite science YouTube channels. They're a fun way of visualizing the effects of vibration and thus sound. The setup is a simple metal plate connected to a device capable of emitting sound to vibrate the plates. Then, covering the surface with sand, the grains of sand will start to rearrange and accumulate, forming patterns that are specific to the sound frequency and the physical properties of this particular plate. Let's simplify this in a single dimension using a string. For instance, a guitar string. When stroking the string, a wave will propagate through the string, then bounce back, making the string resonate and thus making sound. This creates something called a standing wave, where some parts of the string will vibrate a lot, while others will stay completely still. Now, imagine a grain of sand would manage to land on the string, on the part where the vibration is at its peak, called an antinode. The grain of sand would bounce around back and forth until it settles at a still point, called a node. The same thing happens with a two-dimensional plate, and sand will pull at the nodes or nodal lines where the vibration is at its minimum. But enough with the theory stuff, let's fire up Unity and see if we can simulate this. Before I try to make this using particles, I want to do a quick test in a shader to make sure the concept works. The most practical formula I found is this one. It looks scary at first, but there isn't actually much to it. A and B are constants that are specific to the plate we're simulating. The thickness, the kind of metal used, will have an impact on those values. Since we're in a simulation, we'll pick them at random and see which ones make the prettiest patterns. N and M are integers representing modes of vibration. There's some math behind the physics of sound and harmonics that we may want to know about, but ultimately, these two numbers are going to define what the patterns look like. X and Y are simply the coordinates of the current point on the plate, or in our case, the screen. Let's shader graph that And it works! We can play with it! Look at it! So, regarding the N and M integers, you'll notice that when they are equal, the pattern is a simple grid. There seem to be families of patterns depending on the relationship between N and M, and the higher they are, the more lines appear. Let me get out of your way. Meanwhile, the A and B values drive the shape and orientation of the lines. I have a plate, let's add sand to it. I'm using Unity's VFX graph because it runs on the GPU, and that's a good thing when you intend to simulate thousands of grains of sand. Let's start with replicating our formula in VFX graph. Calculating the amplitude of the vibration is basically the same thing as in shader graph. When a grain of sand is in a vibrating area, a random force is applied to it, and the strength of that force is the strength of the vibration of this point. To my surprise, this is enough for the simulation to work great! First try! I'm adding an invisible box that collides with the grains of sand so that they don't fall off when they reach the edges of the plate, and voila! Now, there are still two issues with this. Collisions. After a while, the grains of sand form a very uniform line, where in real life this would not happen as the grains would collide. But there's nothing we can do about that in Unity, so eh. Second issue, shadows. They're also technically not available in VFX graph, but I have a trick up my sleeve. pour a second particle next to each grain of sand, color it black, place it on the ground, and stretch it like a shadow. Does it double the number of particles? Yes. Does my tortured GPU spin its fans at full blast trying to record this video? Also yes. But it's all worth it when you can get some B-roll. Before moving on, I just want to say real quick, I have a Patreon now. If you want to support the channel, you can head over right now and get access to extra video content, the Discord server, make suggestions, and even grab the source code for every project on the channel. I'm posting some bonus content there, outtakes, portions of the video that didn't make the final cut, follow-ups, that sort of thing. For instance, there were many comments under the ASCII rendering video suggesting performance improvements. So I gathered a few of them, implemented them, and profiled their performance to see which one was the most effective. So if you're interested in exclusive content, or simply want to help this channel grow, feel free to check it out at the end of this video. Alright, back to Chladni.
Un, deux, trois.
Bleh. 3D Chladni volumes. I tried to add a new dimension to the formula to make it 3D. I'm kind of improvising this because I couldn't find literature on the subject, but my guess is this would work. Add a new eigenvalue called C, add a new mode value called O, and then jumble together sine waves to make it look like the 2D version, but 3D. And there it is, the Chladni cloud. Hey, so this project was super interesting to make, definitely above my level in terms of math, but I did manage to scrape together a good proof of concept, I think. Of course, you could always skip the math part and simply use a grayscale sprite that shows where the sands should accumulate. Chladni patterns are very pretty, and it's weird to think things are vibrating around us in such ways while we're completely oblivious to it. I tried to imagine how this would fit in a game prototype, but it's too constrained for, say, maze generation, and definitely too resource intensive for simple visual effects. If you want to see more stuff like this, you can subscribe to the channel, hit the bell so you don't miss the next one, and definitely check out the extra content on Patreon. Have a good one!